North Dakota State is the FCS champions again, ninth title in the last 11 seasons. They beat Montana State. I think it was 38-10 was the final.
Pretty beat down. And it was, yes. And if you watched, God, if you like offensive line play, you saw the pushes. I'm talking this offensive line pushed that defensive front for Montana State a good 4 or 5 yards
off the line snap. Every play.
Every snap.
It was so ridiculous. It was a lot of fun to watch if you are rooting for North Dakota State. If you were a Montana State fan, that's rough. That's very rough.
Long day. Long, cold, miserable day.
So it leads to a couple of questions, right? First off, could North Dakota State win the MAC this year? I saw these two questions on Reddit CFB and thought, man, that would be a good topic to discuss for a little bit. Do you think they could have won the MAC in FBS?
It's a hypothetical that we'll never know the answer to.
Right.
So, I mean, could they have competed for the MAC? Sure. Could they have won a lot of games? Yeah. Would they have won it? I don't know. Probably so. I mean, you know, it wouldn't surprise me if they moved into the MAC and then won the MAC.
They have a fantastic system in place.
We saw App State dominate at that level and then come into the Sun Belt and then instantly take over winning the Sun Belt or competing for the Sun Belt every year. I don't know that App State's ever finished less than third in the Sun Belt since they've came in, right?
Correct. They have been dynamic and awesome.
So that wouldn't surprise me. It wouldn't shock me if they moved into a lower level conference like the MAC and instantly, you know, became very competitive. They're really good at football.
And now you say that about different G5 conferences. I don't know that they would be able to do that in the Mountain West this year. I think they could be successful, but that's a different level.
Well, yeah, but I don't know they couldn't either though.
Agreed.
I don't know that they wouldn't.
They've got a really good system, and they've got really good players that fit that system, which leads to the next question that I saw, which is, as a mid-level recruit, would you rather play for a G5 school knowing that you had no shot at a national title, or would you rather play for North Dakota State?
See, some of this all depends on where you're going to school and what life is like. I've said it before, if I wasn't a major college football player, but I could have played football at any G5 school I wanted, who's not picking San Diego State?
Right.
Like, who doesn't want to go to school and have somebody else pay you to live in San Diego? Right? Like, that just seems amazing. And you're telling me my option is to go struggle at San Diego State to be competitive at the mid to upper level Mountain West, or I can win championships. But I gotta live in North Dakota.
Right.
I'm gonna take San Diego. But that's my priorities. Those are things that I care about. All right. I want a little bit of a life. I'd like to have some restaurants to go to. I'd like to have some bars. I'd like to have some. I need a big pool of the opposite sex to choose from. Have you seen me? I can't walk on a campus of 200 people and hope that one of those 100 of the opposite sex finds me attractive. That's not going to work out well for me. Right? That's a bad deal. Right? I need to be in a big city, but that's what I want out of college. So what do most of these kids want? I think some of them would choose that, which is why they get the talent that they get. They get legit NFL talent from there.
Yes.
And it's real, but I don't.
Well, it's talent that still needs to be developed. Right. And that's the difference.
I don't know that enough is coming from there to sway the mid-level guys, because some of these college towns, and I picked San Diego, but some of these other college towns, Boise is an awesome town to live in, okay? Yeah. Awesome.
UCF, FAU.
Well, now you're getting into the South and you start getting into the Sun Belt and those types of areas. You got some really cool areas. But even in the MAC, like you're in Midwest, but the Midwest area of a lot of these college towns, they're quaint, they're nice, they're big enough. You're a good drive away. Like, you're usually 45 minutes or an hour away from a good city. And there's lots to do. I'm not besmirching the great state of North Dakota, but it's fucking North Dakota, man.
Yeah. Fargo is the biggest city out there.
There's nothing to do.
Yes. I mean, it's rough. It's very rough.
There's a reason they're really good at football, because they don't have anything else to do.
You were not wrong. You were not wrong about that.
It is cool to watch them. I like watching them, but would I go there? No. And would the majority of mid-level recruits go there? No. And we've seen that. There's correct. A reason. No, they're just not getting all of the mid-level talent, or even the bulk of the, they're not hand selecting their guys the way Alabama just hand selects their guys.
Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com. And if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.